September 24th, 1983, an 11-year-old girl, Sabrina Bowie, was raped and strangled, and two men were accused of the crime. One of them was Antonia Brown. She was left to die in a soybean field in North Carolina. Now, how many of you guys believe that Antonia Brown should have been sentenced to death? I mean, personally, I believe that he should be too. Now, after he was arrested, he was taken for questioning. For 5 hours, he was denied access to a lawyer, water. And after the 5 hours, he confessed to the murder, and he confessed to the rape, and he implicated his younger brother. 30 years later, they found out that he didn't rape that girl, nor did he kill her, because of new DNA evidence that they didn't have before. This story is far too common in our judicial system. Not all are freed before, and unfortunately, not all people are freed before their execution. That grants the posthumous freedom to the system, so later they can free people when they're accused. Freedom to those who are later found innocent. I've read books, taken opinions of students, and I've talked to my history teacher in depth about the death penalty. The cost to taxpayer, the three most important things to know about the death penalty is the cost to the taxpayers, inherent unfairness and racial biases, and failure to deter crimes. Then I'll explain the solution. So first, let's talk about the cost. All right, so $740 million is what it takes to keep a person on life sentence. But you'd be surprised that it takes $1.26 million to kill a person. And I'm not really that good at math, but that's $460,000 that would be saved by putting a person in life sentences. Keeping the death row active in the state of California costs $90,000 more monthly for your average taxpayer combined, like for overall population. If California had outlawed the death penalty in the last 20 years, they would have saved $5 billion. That's $5 billion that would have been spent for education or reform. Now we'll talk about the color of justice. Applied arbitrarily and very biasly, 40% of death row inmates are actually African American, and that's really, really bad, considering that only 12.3% of our population is African American. 130 people have been freed from their death row cases due to evidence they found later, and that's 130 people that we would have killed legally and by going by the system. 40% of those 130 people that were freed are African American, and 35% of African Americans were later found innocent after they were killed. So now we've talked about the cost and racial biases. The system is flawed, so the solution is simple. We have to urge our Congress to abolish the death penalty. Professor Radula and Tracy from Colorado University found that 88% of criminologists don't believe that the death penalty is ineffective. 78% of the 100 people interviewed said that it doesn't murder the murder rate. 91% of politicians say it to sound tough, but really it's just a way for them to distract from the real problems. The real problems that we need to focus on are drug usage and the war against drugs and gun reform. And they've also said that people should start advocating for longer prison sentences. People don't think of the death penalty when acting, so it doesn't deter any crime. When a person kills someone,